My only weakness.
I wish the camera was on me. When you talk clutch quarterbacks this season, my eyes rolled so far I got dizzy. Deshaun Watson might not be the first name that comes to mind, but he's actually been better than most in those situations. Tied with Drew Brees for the most fourth quarter comebacks this season with 5. The Texans face a tough challenge as they battle for seeding in the AFC. They get the Eagles on Sunday. Here's what Deshaun Watson had to say about those clutch situations.
You've been through those situations before, so you learn through, the tight ball games. But, for me and understanding, if you look at all the games, majority of the games are very, very close, regardless if they're home or away. So, you just got to be prepared for every situation. And you got to be very good in situational football, especially down stretch, because majority of the games are going to come down to, that last drive or, the last couple minutes. For, guys on the defense or special teams, putting the ball back in my hands and giving us a chance on offense to go down and win the game or put the game away, it gives them a lot of confidence. So, it's a lot of confidence with the ball in my hands, and I'm going to continue to, build that trust and respect throughout the locker room.
CeCe, I actually don't think his answer did his game justice. I think he kind of chalked it up to, well, I'm confident, and you've been in a situation once or twice, you pretty much know what to do. There are very good quarterbacks that have done it before that aren't doing it as well as Deshaun Watson. What makes him so good in clutch situations?
The thing about it, there's a number of things that have to happen. One is something you just can't see. There's just certain guys in stressful situations, they just don't get stressed out. And they're able to, instead of it heighten them in their overall reaction, they are able to calm down in intense situations and be able to do what they have prepared to do. Other people, they start thinking faster. The faster the game is played, faster the game is played in their head. And it typically plays out where we as fans, we can tell the difference between, those are guys that are just playmakers. They are ballers, and that's what he is. His ability to be able to make quick decisions and get rid of the football. Now, what I worry about in this game, he has been successful. But when they don't have a running game, that offensive line is not great. How is he able to know the difference when getting rid of a bad play? Because they're going to be on top of him. And how do I hold it a little bit longer and wait for one of my wide receivers to be open? Because that's what I believe the game will be determined. I believe offensively, Philadelphia is going to have some success. And if they're going to win, Deshaun might have to be in a comeback situation or in a one-score game. But I believe with the pass rush of Philadelphia, he's going to have to be careful in holding on to the ball and realize that if the play is over, to let the play be over and not let it lead to a couple different mistakes.
But, and to speak to that, as far as knowing to get rid of the ball, he's the only quarterback in the league that's been sacked more than Dak. And so some of that is his doing, some of that is the offensive line's doing, but it's not all the offensive line, bad as it was certainly early in the year. And it's not great now, but it's not the total train wreck it was early in the year. But this clutch stuff is, this is the reason we didn't have the TV show yet, but why, when his draft was happening, I thought he should have been, no question about it, the first quarterback taken. Now, he was the third quarterback taken. I didn't see the Mitch Trubisky stuff at all. And I, if I'm being honest, I didn't see Pat Mahomes being this. I don't know that anyone saw him being this. But I watched him at Clemson. I watched him in the college football playoff. And I said, if this guy stays healthy, he has it. He has
what?
The ability.
What is that? What is it?
Well, it is not just staying calm in the biggest in the most pressure-packed situations, but the very special guys get better when the stakes are the highest. Mm-hmm. Like, if you look at athletes across all sports, guys that can just maintain their regular level of play in the most clutch situations are great. Like, most guys get a little bit worse in those spots. Right. There's a select few that get
now,
a little bit better.
We've seen a lot of players in college be very, very successful. But what Nick is saying is, I saw this not only against college football, not only in the SEC, very, very respectable, but more importantly, I saw this against a professional Alabama team.
Twice in the national championship game. Twice. I saw him come this close and lose, and then come this close and win. And so to see, like, that is the closest facsimile of an NFL defense you're going to play in the highest stress spot. And I saw him do it. And I said, okay, like, if this guy's healthy, I know he can make the throws. I like his athleticism. And the it factor, it's why I'm always skeptical of the quarterback that my knock on Mitch Trubisky was, we've never seen him in a big game. The last big game he played in was in whatever high school state quarterfinal or semifinal he was in. Like, 1 year at North Carolina, I don't know if he has that. I still don't know if he has that.
Give me two quarterbacks not named Rodgers and Brady who are as clutch or who were the epitome of clutch the way he's trying to be one day.
Baker Mayfield. Baker Mayfield's got that it factor. Like, he is clutch. He is also, he's a leader. One of Deshaun's things, not only the clutch, how do you know a leader? Look behind him and look how many people follow him at Clemson. Dynamic leader. Came to the NFL, took over this franchise. So, Baker Mayfield, I would say, one, I'm going to put in that class immediately, and Patty Mahomes. I mean, Patty Mahomes, I mean, goodness gracious.
I'm in history, but okay.
Catch up commercials, yeah. But young guys who I expect to be doing this in the NFL for the next 10 years, those three quarterbacks right
and
there.
And the guys from, you mean, still playing but have already proven it, he's not the guy anymore, but Eli. I mean, that's what Eli's whole game was. Yeah. Was Eli was able to, he didn't drop off at all, no matter how big the stakes were. I don't know that he got a lot better, but when everyone around you is getting worse and you're able to maintain that level no matter how big the game is, that's what allowed him to have the success that he had when the Giants were a really good football team.
All right, let's move on to the Chiefs. Speaking of Patty Mahomes, they face a tough road challenge as they travel to Seattle. Mahomes and Russell Wilson, they both have a lot in common. Yeah, sure. Both rank in the top five in passer rating. Both go off script and give defenses fits. Both were actually drafted to play baseball. Good thing that didn't work out. Here's what Seahawks coach Pete Carroll had to say about facing Kansas City.
They have shown everything now. You know, we've seen them. You know, after all these games, we know what kind of the whole scope of this offense is. The first month of the season, everybody was kind of on their heels. And so hopefully we can, you know, settle into it. It's not that it gets easy because they have such a diverse attack that, you know, you got to be ready for a lot of stuff. But, you know, our guys are, you know, they're up for it. They're ready for the challenge and all of that. And we got to do a great job on their really classy receivers. You know, Kelce and Hill are just unbelievably talented guys, having great years. So there's a lot of issues here. So I think our guys will be ready to do this.
All right, CeCe, I'm going to ask you the same question that opponents have been asking about this Chiefs team all season long. How do you slow down Patrick Mahomes and that offense?
The first thing you got to do in this game is you got to make sure your offense understands the firepower that's on the other side. And you can't turn the ball over. You can't go three and out. You can't put them on a short field. In third down situation, man, that's the most important down, to be able to advance those sticks, to be able to give yourself another 3 to 4 chances to be able to advance the ball. When you're playing against these high-powered teams, don't try to attack the offense with your defense. No. Go in the offensive room and tell them, guys, they're going to score 30 on us if you guys turn the ball over. All right, if you guys can win time possession, if we can win the turnover battle, I believe it's got to be 34 to 35 minutes time possession on Seattle's running game. They're number one in the National Football League. So what you have to do is you have to make Kansas City play at a pace that they're not comfortable. And the reason why is because not only playing against Seattle's defense, but they're playing against the clock. You also have to get the lead. You can't turn the ball. You can't give Patty Mahomes a couple extra possessions. So those are the things that would have to happen. And one guy from the defense, we talk about Bobby Wagner, great linebacker that they have for Seattle. If Frank Clark does not have a great game, I think it's impossible for Seattle to win. So those are the three things. Time possession, I need 33 to 35 minutes. I need a turnover battle. I need to win that by +2. And Frank Clark, you heard about him 2 weeks ago. He said that's his defense. Richard Sherman, it's not his defense anymore. Okay, Frank Clark, this is the type of game that Richard Sherman and the Legion of Boom, that they would do something to tilt the field in the favor of Seattle.
And what you're talking about, if the way to beat the Chiefs is don't turn the ball over and be able to win time possession by running, that way no team is better suited than Seattle. Seattle is only first in two offensive categories. They are the number one rushing team in football, and they have the fewest turnovers in football. So, like, as far as them not turning the ball over themselves and then being able to run the ball, I watched them against the Rams after the Dante Fowler strip sack to put the Rams up 12. There was 5 minutes left in this football game. Seattle's down 12. You know what they were doing? Running.
Yep.
They 5 minutes left, down 2 scores. We are going to stay doing what we do. And it damn near worked for them. They scored and they got the ball back for one last chance to try to win that football game. They are not going to abandon the run. They could be down 14 points, and they won't abandon the run. The key for me with Kansas City, because if the Chiefs are the team that I believe they are, which is the best team in the NFL, they know what's at stake in this game. They know the difference between being the 1 seed and the 5 seed, and they also know whether, even though they won't admit it, week 17 is as close to a bye as you can get. They're at home against the Raiders. And so if they win this game, they're going to be the 1 seed. If they're the team that I think they are going to win this game unless that crowd adds, forget a 12th man, a 13th, and a 14th man via pre-snap penalties. If the Chiefs are getting false starts and if they are
and that's
not,
something we're concerned about with the Chiefs in
a
big
lot of penalties.
Spots, not time of possession, but all those penalties, will they be able to overcome first and 20, first and 15? Those are things that really, if offense can't stay on schedule, like, are they going to run the ball? And how many penalties or bad situations will they be in?
And if you're so concerned about penalties, are you as an offensive lineman getting a beat and a half late on the snap?
Yes.
To where Frank Clark is already has you beat before you get out of your stance.
Mm-hmm.
Like, that's something. So for Mitchell Schwartz, who's the right tackle who should have been a Pro Bowler, for Eric Fisher, who's the left tackle who was a Pro Bowler, those two guys got to be on the snap count and got to be ready, because that's a way the game can be wrecked. A Pat Mahomes strip sack, a tipped pass that turns into a turnover. Because what we know is the Chiefs can score, and in Seattle's time with Russell Wilson, they're 4-27 if the opponent breaks 24 points. The Chiefs have broken 24 points every game all year.
Wow.
So unless they turn the ball over a bunch, they should be fine. But that's how they would turn the ball over. That's what they got to be concerned about.
All right, let's take a break. Bart Scott.